Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can implement algorithms related to matrix addition, subtraction and transpose using C language, right? So first I am picking matrix addition. So let's implement the function. So name of function is matrix addition. It will be requiring some parameters. So let's say first parameter is first matrix whose dimension is A33. Then second parameter is second matrix whose dimension is also 33. Then third parameter, third matrix which is also having size as 33. Then in R1 int C1, int R2 and int C2. So R1 and C1 is for rows and column of first matrix, R2 and C2 is for rows and column for second matrix. Now inside this we can implement two variables as ij. Then we need to apply if condition. So we need to check whether row 1 is equal to R2 or C1 is equal to R2. If anyone is unequal, then we can stop this method, right? And here I am writing R1 is not equal to R2 or C1 is not equal to C2. So if any one of this is true, then we can write printf addition not possible and return. So return will stop the execution of this method if this condition is true. If this condition is false, then we can apply the addition operation. So for that we can implement a loop. So it will be for rows, so you can use R1 or R2, because if both are equal then only we will be having execution of these statements. So you can use R1 or R2, or both will be correct. Then second loop, that you need to repeat until C1 or C2, whichever you want to write. And inside this you can write C of ij equals to A of ij plus B of ij. So this way A matrix index values will be added with B matrix index values and their sum will be added to C matrix. And then you can close these loops, right? And close the main function. And you can put the return type of this function as void, because we are not going to return any value. And the sum will be available into C matrix. So let's suppose you are calling this method from main function. So in main function, you need to read A and B values from user. And after reading those values from user, the sum will be performed with this method. And this method will be updating the values of C matrix automatically. So here you can see we have not printed the values of C matrix, but after calling this method in main function, and its completion will be returning the updated values of C matrix. So after calling this method, you can just print the value of C matrix. So that will be the sum of two matrices, right? So this way I explain you how you can write function to add two matrix in C. Then you can just convert this function into subtraction as well. So from here you can remove add and put subtract. Rest of the things will be same. Here also you need to write subtraction, and instead of plus you can use minus. So this is the method that will be performing subtraction operation. So subtraction logic is similar to addition, just you need to place the plus with minus, right? Now after explaining addition and subtraction, now we need to understand how we can write the code for transpose. So So I am erasing these. So in case of transpose, we just require only one matrix as input, and then we can print the transpose of that matrix. So I hope you know the logic of transpose. We need to print rows in column, or you can say columns into rows. So now I am going to write that. So void transpose, here I am writing int a 3x3, then we can also receive rows and column values so that we can iterate the loop. So here I am writing two variables, I and j. For iterating the loop, I am going to use r and c values. So here I am writing I equals to 0, I less than r, I plus plus, then for j equals to 0, j less than c, and j plus plus. So first loop will be repeating r times, and second loop will be repeating c times. Now inside this second loop, I can write printf percent d and a of ji. So normally, whenever we want to print a matrix, we use aij. But if you want to print its transpose, then in that case, you need to use aji. Then you can close this loop. Then you can write printf backslash n, and then you can close. So let's say if we have a matrix of 3x3 size and we have these values, and these are the indexes. Now I is starting from 0, then j is also starting from 0. So first time 0 index value will be printed, that is 1. Now j will be incremented only, so j is 1, right? So j is 1 and I is 0. So again, we need to print a ji. So j is 1 and I is 0. So first time 1 was printed, now this 4 will be printed after this 1. Then again j will be incremented. So j is 2 this time. So we need to print 2 0 index. So that is 7. So here you can see column values are printed in terms of rows. So that is transpose. You need to print all the columns in form of rows. So your matrix will convert into transpose, or you can say your matrix is printed in form of transpose. So this way, I hope you understood how we can write a function in C so that we can implement transpose algorithm, or you can say we can implement the algorithm that is related to transpose in C language. So you can call this function into main. Main will be passing 2D array, row and column size. And this code will be printing transpose of that matrix. So I hope this way you understood how we can implement algorithms related to addition, subtraction, and transpose in C language. So you can implement three different functions. First is for addition, second for subtraction, and third for transpose. And you can call all those three functions into main so that individual outputs will be printed on output. So this way, I completed my explanation related to these topics in this video. If you want to watch more algorithm or their implementation using C related video, so you can go to description of this video and you will find links of playlists. So you can follow those playlists so that you can understand how we can write algorithms and how we can convert those algorithms with the help of C language. Thank you for watching this video.